Thank you. treatment of a malnourished patient using the MOS too.
Before I started Dermatica, my skin, I would say, was an absolute mess. Started using it and saw results within 2 months, so I was really, really pleased. And it's the one brand that's helped me feel like I can maybe go back outside again without makeup on.
This video, we are going to be considering assessment of a malnourished patient using the MOS tool. And this happens to fall in your new OSCE, your new test of competency. So the new test of competency, you might be having MAST. So all you need to do is you're going to have, this is your MAST chart, and it's going to be scored for you, all right? Your MAST chart is going to be scored for you. All you need to do is to ask the questions and total them. You are going to be having your news charts, and you have to do your observation and chart accordingly. You are going to be having this as well. We're going to be having this as well. You're going to be having this as well. You're going to be having this for your MOS. So I will be taking you through step by step of assessing MOS in the new test of competency. So in the new test of competency, you'll be having your MOS 2 charts and you'll be having your MOS. So like I told you, this will be scored for you. They will circle the questions they need you to ask for you. It will be scored for you. When you score it, then you can now tell the patient if the patient is having low risk malnutrition, high risk malnutrition, or medium risk malnutrition. Okay, so it is really, really simple, guys. I'll tell you for free. OSCE is simple. Nurses are brilliant. Don't be scared. Don't be scared at all. So I'll be doing this in a practical setting. And my son will be acting as my patient, and you will then get the knowledge needed for this assessment. If you have any question, please feel free to pop it up on the YouTube channel. I'm more than happy to answer your questions and your inquiries, because why, after all this knowledge shared in this channel, you're not serious. So please hit the subscribe button, share this video with your friends preparing for OSCE exam. The aim of this channel is to make sure every one of us passes our OSCE exam in one sniffing, and I'm not joking about it, in one sniffing. All right, guys, so I'll be starting now. And so if you have any question, don't forget to, you know, pop up your question, and I'm more than happy to answer your question. So welcome back, and let's talk about A to E assessments of a MOS patient using the MOS charts. All right, guys, come, and let's dissect this. Hey, lovely people, so welcome back to my channel, and let's dissect A to E assessment of a MOS patient in the new test of competency. So the first thing you do first is to do your hand hygiene. Of course, your assessor is going to say to you, assume all checks have been done. So I do my hand hygiene according to World Health Organization. Palm to palm, right palm over left dorsum, vice versa. Fingers into this, fingers into locks, rotation of the top, tip to the finger, and the wrist. So my hands are clean. I will now read my scenario. I'm just reading my scenario to have an idea of the patient. So I'm having a MOS patient, okay? I'm having a MOS patient, all right. So you will have your MOS 2 charts. You will have your MOS, which has already been scored for you. We have the treatment recommendation, and we have this, and this. All right, so now I can approach my patient. Hello.
Hi.
My name is Violet. I'm one of the nurses who will be looking after you today. Can I please know your full name and date of birth, please?
My name is Penny Brooke.
And your date of birth, please?
15 February 1940.
Fantastic. Can I double check that with your wristband?
Okay.
Fantastic. So imagine the wristband. I have here Haley Group, date of birth 15 February 1940, hospital number 100010. Assessor, with the paperwork I have on my hand, I can confirm to you I have the right patient. So Haley, do you have any allergies at all?
Yeah, I'm allergic to nuts.
Oh, bless you. So what happens when you take peanuts?
I actually have rashes on all of my
body. Oh, bless you. I can assure you, that's why you're having a red wristband. Nobody will give you anything containing peanuts. Is that okay?
All right,
fantastic. So the reason I'm here this morning is because I want to assess you. I want to carry out an E2E assessment on you using the bus chart. Is this a convenient time?
Yes, it is.
You sure you don't want to use the washroom?
No.
All right, I'll just ask you some few questions now. Can you confirm to me that your height is 1.60 meters and your weight is 70 kg? Is that correct, Haley?
Yes, that's correct.
Oh, fantastic. So, I move over to step one. BMI score, and BMI score is actually your weight and your height. So from what I have here, you are having a score of 0, meaning that for BMI score, you fall within the normal range. So I'm happy with that. There is no problem with that. All right. So I move over to step two. Step two means weight loss score in the last 3 to 6 months. And from what I have here, you have lost between 5% to 10% in the last 3 to 6 months. Is that true, Amy?
Yes, that's true.
Why is that so? Why have you lost weight?
That's because I lost my dog recently.
Oh,
because
of that, you.
I've not been eating properly like the way I used to.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. I'm really so sorry to hear that. So how long have you been with your dog before you lost him?
Like a week now. I've been with my dog for over 2 years.
Wow. So is that why you've not been eating well?
Yeah.
Oh, I can imagine the attachment you've had with your dog. I'm so sorry about the loss of your dog, all right? But like what I can say to you, I really have to encourage you to eat. Try to eat small amounts of feed at regular intervals, all right? And do you want me to refer you to the dietitian?
Yes, of course.
Okay, because it's going to help you. They're going to plan your diet with you and you can start eating. What do you like eating?
I like eating rice.
Okay, fruits, vegetables. And I think I was telling to the doctor, they just might have multivitamins for you. Maybe up to them entirely, okay? So I move over to step three. For step three, it is called acute disease effect score. I'm happy to say to you that you are not having any score for that, and I'm very happy with that. All right? So I'm just going to total your score. Is that okay? All right. So total must score is 1. I'm going to write the dates. The dates they gave me on my scenario is 22nd of June 2022. The time they gave me on my scenario is 10 o'clock, and I'll put my signature. So, Haley, now I want to tell the patient what is their must score and the treatment recommendation. So, Haley, you are having a must score of 1. I didn't say you are having a score of 1, you know what I mean? You are having a must score of 1. So, a must score of 1 is called medium risk malnutrition, all right? So, we are going to be documenting your dietary intake for 3 days. If it's adequate, we are going to repeat screening, okay? Because you are in the community, it's going to be done monthly. If you are in the hospital, like you are now, it's going to be done weekly. If you are in the community, so either of the category you fall into. If you are in the hospital, you are in the hospital, like okay, we're going to be doing it weekly. If you are in a care home, we'll be doing it monthly. If you are in the community, we'll be doing it 2 to 3 months, okay? So if it's inadequate, we are going to be setting clinical concerns, follow local policy, set goals, improve and increase your viral nutritional intake. Is that okay? So guys, I did not cram that. It is here. So you just read it out for the patient. Are you happy for us to do this for you?
Yes.
All right, fantastic. Thank you very much, Haley. So Haley, I'm just going to leave you on a call here and I'll assemble all my business to do your observations. Is that okay, my love?
All right.
Fantastic. So I'll put my hand on you now. Palm to palm, right palm over left goes on, vice versa, fingers interlace, fingers interlock, rotation on the top, rotation on the top, tips to the finger, tips to the finger, end of the wrist. So my hands are clean. I'll put on my apron. I'll
I used to work 9 to 5, but what made me a millionaire was working a few minutes every day at 5 to 9. Let me show you how. Sure, you're making money doing what?
Assessor, please can you confirm to me my equipment is clean and ready for use? Fantastic. All right, so I'm going to just take my dilemma and I'll proceed to my patient. Hello, baby, I'm back. Are you still happy for us to continue?
Yeah.
All right, fantastic. So, Haley, can I check your left hand, please? Have you ever had surgery on this hand? Do you know?
No.
All right, fantastic. Now, let me just take off the skin, okay? So, Haley, when I tie this off, you are going to feel some tightness, okay? But it's just for a while, okay? Can I check your knee beds quickly? I see your knee beds. Don't mind my son, he's training knees. So just do as if he's not training knees. I see your knee beds. There are no infection. There are no false knees. I do a capillary refill. I'll use the first finger. I do a capillary refill. And the verbalize is less than 2 seconds. So I put my imaginary probe. All right, I'm just going to put on my machine now. Okay. So, while that is going on, I'm going to pick up my news cards. I'll make sure the patient's name is there. It will be there. If it's not there, you write it. I'll make sure the patient's date of birth is there. If it's not there, you write it. I'll make sure the date of admission is there. And the date of admission they gave for me is 20th of June. So, I'll write 20th of June here, 2022. Now, the small date and the small time, I'll make sure I put 20th of June and I'll put my time. And my time is what? So I'll just check that whatever. Alright, Peggy, thank you very much. Your blood pressure is 134/70. You want to look properly when you are chatting, because if it's 134/70 and you don't chat it in 150, it is a fail. Alright? So I want to look properly that I'm chatting at 134/70. I'm looking properly. And the saturation is 96. I'll put a dot there. Thank you very much. Can I take this one first? Fantastic. Thank you so much for your cooperation. So, can I quickly check your pulse, please? Is that okay? All right. I'm going to be putting my 2 fingers on your radial artery, okay? And I'll be counting for 2 minutes, okay? On the exam day, the nurse's breast watch is on the table. So, pick it up and count. So, let's do this now. Now I've counted the pulse for 1 minute. I'll cram the value without the patient knowing and I'll start counting from rising and falling in the chest. All right, thank you very much, Katie. I'm just going to chat that now, okay? My pulse is 80 beats per minute and my respiration is, our respiration is 20 pounds per minute. So, Katie, I actually counted your pulse for 1 minute. Respiration for 1 minute, but I didn't want to let you know because I didn't want to stop the movie. All right, I hope that is fine. All right, so I see you're not on oxygen, so you are saturating on air. So I'm going to put air here, and I see you are alert because you're talking to me, obviously. So I'm happy with that. Can I check your skin, please?
All right,
fantastic. If you've not watched my video on your skin updates, we no longer check the ears, we use the forehead, all right, or you use the temporal region. I can see your skin. There is no excessive sweating, there is no redness. I'm happy to take your temperature. Alright, temperature 37.1. So, my chart 37.1. I'm looking at my news chart now. My temperature test. Alright, there is no red temporal region. I can see your skin. There is no excessive sweating. There is no redness. I'm happy to take your temperature. All right. Temperature 37.4. I'm looking at my new strap now. I'm going to get a new scooter. Look very well at your new strap, making sure you charted everything correctly. So my new scooter is zero. I'm not cramming anything. I'll come to the back and check the treatment recommendation.
Okay, this is going to sound a little nuts, but the fastest and easiest way to make passive online income on Amazon is to never sell physical products. I never have, and Amazon's consistent.
So, Haley, you are having a new score of zero. Nothing at all to worry about, okay? I'll be monitoring you 12 hourly, and I'm free the money to escalate your care, okay? So I'm happy with that. So Haley, I need to go back to Airway. For your Airway, because you are talking to me, we've been interacting, I have confirmed that your Airway is patent, meaning there is no obstruction to your Airway. Or do you think you have any obstruction to your Airway? Your Airway is patent. Alright, fantastic. I will go back to Airway. For briefly, Haley, I counted your respiration for 1 minute. The rate, the depth, your respiration is fine. It is 20 beats a minute. There is no stridor. There is no visual sign of respiratory distress. There is no unequal entry of air. There is no coughing. I'm very happy with your respiration, okay? So when I also did your saturation, remember when I checked your name there, I popped it through. I did your saturation was 96. That's perfect. That's okay? So I move over to saturation. For saturation, I did your blood pressure, and your blood pressure was 134 over 70. That's normal. I'm very happy with that as well, okay? So I counted your pulse for 1 minute. The strength of your pulse, the rhythm of your pulse, and the reading of your pulse is okay. Nothing to worry about. Is that okay? I also checked your skin when I did your capillary refill. You were properly perfused, and there is no cyanosis. So I'm very happy with that as well, okay? So I move over to disability. What disability, sorry? Do you know where you are at the moment?
Yes.
Where are you? Oh, fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. So you know where you are. Are you having any pain? Any pain at all? You don't have anything. That's fine. I'm also happy with that. How is your urine output? Are you passing good amount of urine? Is your urine color okay?
My urine is very dark.
Can I get that again, please?
It's very dark.
Oh, bless you. Are you drinking well?
No.
Oh, that's the problem. You know, sometimes when we don't drink well, our urine becomes like concentrated. So, like I said, I want to encourage you to be drinking. I know it's not easy. Just be sipping. Have some sip of water, but I'm also referring you to the dietitian, okay? And I'll be happy to get a sample from your urine as well. So let me know so that we'll get a sample from your urine, okay? Fantastic. How about your blood glucose? Did anyone check your blood glucose at all? Oh, no one has checked your blood glucose. Leave that to me, okay? When I'm done with my observation with you, I'll come and check your blood glucose, okay? Alright, fantastic. So I move over to exposure. For exposure, I give your temperature, it was 37.1, I'm happy with that, okay? Do you have any rash, any wound, any swelling in any part of your body at all?
No,
are you sure? Alright, so I'm very happy with that, I don't have. So, like I said to you, I just want to ask you just a few more questions again. How is your mobility?
I mobilize very well, but I'm mobilized
with a stick. With a stick, and you're confident with mobilizing with a stick? All right, I'm quite happy with that, but I'm thinking maybe I should refer you to the occupational therapy just to, you know, check on you, check your mobility, because I see from your scenario you have a past medical history of osteoarthritis.
Yes.
Yeah, so although you said you're good with the stick, but you've not really been eating, so you might just be at risk for fall. So I'm not saying anything, I just want the occupational therapy to, you know, assess your mobility. That's okay. Fantastic. So I'm happy with that. So you said you're not eating well, don't you? So I'll refer you to the dietitian that we agree, okay? So do you smoke or drink alcohol?
No.
Oh, fantastic. That sounds good to me. So do you have any concerns at all for me?
No.
You're happy with everything we've done today?
Yes.
Fantastic. Do you? Okay, that's fine. I wanted to ask, do you live alone?
Yes, I do.
Be living with your home. So you obviously you're living with your dog. Alright. So your occupational therapy can take you off from there and, you know, assess your home living, okay? Thank you very much, Amy, for your cooperation. I'll leave you with a call bed. If you need anything at all you need is to use your call bed, and I'll be here or any other diagnosis. Alright? So thank you. I had that dream. So guys, thank you so much for watching. And keep sharing this video to all who are preparing for the OSCE exam, okay? So thank you so much for watching. Special thanks to my lovely son for always helping me in making videos. So thank you so much. I really appreciate you for always helping me make videos. So guys, keep watching. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to subscribe. I will see you in my next video on GCS in the new test of competency. And until then, keep passing your OSCE exam. I love you all and bye.
eToro presents How to Copy Investors in 30 Seconds. So just open.
My name is Jamie and I will be your nurse for today. I will be administering your suppository because you have been experiencing constipation the last 3 days. Will that be alright, Aiden? Before that, can I please confirm your full name and your date of birth? Can I just double check it with your ID band? Aiden, I can also see you have a red eye Japan. Are you allergic to food, drug, or latex? Okay. Alright, I will just prepare your equipment and I will also read your prescription chart. Is that alright, Aiden? Prescription chart for Aiden Awang, date of birth 8/9/1975, hospital number 09815324. Ward Sidmouth Ward, date of admission today, height 1.65, weight 68 kilograms, body mass index 24.9, consultant Dr. Smith, time of admission 6 o'clock. Number of prescription records, chart 1 of 1. All prescribers must complete the signature record. Name Dr. Smith, GMC 987-45612, signature Dr. Smith, blip 789. Details of person administering medication, none listed. Alerts, allergies, medicine, paracetamol, effects, rashes. Signature Dr. Smith, leak number 789, date today. Medication risk factors not listed. Next page. All the details are the same with the previous page. Information for prescribers of medicine, non-administration, self-administration, all written below. Once only medication, date today, drug glycerol, dose 4 grams, route per rectum, instructions for constipation, time required 8 o'clock. Prescriber signature, print name and group number, Dr. Smith 789. Pharmacy check, Loisa Groom. I can confirm that the prescription chart is complete, signed and dated, and is due my time. Next page. All the details are the same with the previous page. Prescribed oxygen, there are no prescribed oxygen. Next page. All the details are the same with the previous page. There are no antimicrobials prescribed. Next page, all the details are the same with the previous page. Regular medications, there are no prescribed regular medications. Next page, details are the same with the previous page. As required medications, there are no prescribed as required medications. Next page, all the details are the same with the previous chart. Infusions, there are no IV infusions prescribed, and there are no listed omitted doses of medicine, coded and delayed doses. I have my gauze, packaging is dry and intact, expiration date is 2027, I'm happy to use. My Optilube, lubricating jelly, packaging is dry and intact, expiration date is 2026, I'm happy to use. I have here my glycerol, 4 grams, packaging is dry and intact, expiration date is 2026, make sure to place an under pad or incontinence pad underneath your Botox and your hips. Is that alright? Hi Dad, I will also make sure to assist you on your left lateral side with your knees flexed, feet level or slightly raised, and also your Botox near the edge of the bed. Is that alright, Ida? I will now check for the perianal area. I will make sure to observe for any evidence of skin soreness, excoriation, swelling, hemorrhoids, rectal prolapse, or infestation. And I can see that the site is clean and there are no signs of infection. I'm happy to proceed. I will now lubricate the suppository using the blunt end. I will now insert the suppository using the blunt end for 2 to 4 cm and making sure to stretch the Botox. Then I will just wipe off the excess lubricating jelly from your perianal and your perineal areas, okay? Then I would like to advise you to stay lying down for 20 minutes or until you are not able to do so. Is that alright? Are you comfortable at the moment? Alright, if you need the toilet, here's the call bell. Press the buzzer and we'll be right there for you, alright? Thank you, Aiden.
Thank you. patron, and you need to talk at the end. So it's a mixture of a stick.
Microgram nebulizer, Dr. Campbell, was free LSJP 10:30 today, 11 o'clock, paracetamol, 1,000 milligram IV, local glucose 3, given by NSJP 11. Prescribed oxygen therapy, date is today, time is 10, prescriber signature and date, Dr. Campbell, glucose 3, target oxygen saturation is 94% to 98%. Percent. Therapy instructions as to maintain saturations as per target. Patient is on a reservoir mask up to 15 liter per minute. Time started 10 and time discontinued by signature 13. Assessor, please can I know my patient oxygen saturation right now?
Okay. I move on to PRN as required medications. Date by today. Drug name is paracetamol. The dose is 1,000 mg. Route is by oral instruction. 4 days power for pain. Prescriber signature and bleep. Dr. Khan, bleep number 1, 2, 3. Also today we have salbutamol 5 mg. The route is nebulizer. Instruction as required. Prescriber's signature and bleep, Dr. Khan, and bleep number 1, 2, 3. So, Terry, can I confirm with you? Are you having any pain currently?
Yes, ma'am.
Please, where are you having the pain?
Okay.
In your chest. Is the pain radiating?
No,
okay, so at the scale of 0 and 10 to 10, 10 being the highest, can you score your pain for me?
Four.
Okay, so you'll be needing an adjustment, isn't it?
Yes.
So I'll be giving you paracetamol to help with the pain. Is that okay?
Yes.
Also, do you have difficulty? How are you feeling? Do you have any difficulty with breathing now?
I'm fine.
Okay, so I will not be giving you salbutamol with that. So I'm going to the next stage. From the last time it was given. So Terry, if you don't mind, I'm sorry about that. So I will be delaying with the paracetamol in as much as you're having pain. But then because we're giving paracetamol IV at 10 at 11 a.m., which is not up to 4 hours. So maybe you want to wait and then later on I will see if I have to give you the paracetamol. Is that okay by you?
That's fine.
It's okay.
Moving on to the next page, prescription charts for Terry Potter with other information same as previous antimicrobials. We have co-amoxiclav prescribed today 500 milligram over 125 milligram. Start date today, finish date in 5 days, to be taken 3 times daily via the mouth. Duration 5 days. Prescriber signature and date and bleep, Dr. Khan, 1, 2, 3. Today at 800, JV did not administer the medication because patient was not on the ward and patient is due to have this medication at this time. My patient is allergic to penicillin, so I'm not administering it. Terry, I can say you're allergic to penicillin, and co-amoxiclav is a derivative of penicillin, so I won't administer that to you. Is that okay? If, however, I'll escalate this and fill it in this form, okay? So the next medication is clarithromycin, prescribed today 500 mg, to be taken twice daily via the mouth. Start date today, finish date in 5 days. Prescriber signature and give Dr. Khan, glucose with me. Duration is 5 days, time 1100, administered by JV. Next time it will be due is 2300. So, Khan, you are not due for clarithromycin, so I will administer that to you, okay?
So, I move on to the next chart. Prescription chart for the reporter details are covered as the previous chart. So, regular drug, geophylline. Starts today is 200. Start the exam is today, finish date is 5 days. The date is today, dose is 200 mg, frequency is once daily, route is for oral, duration is 5 days, time given by 11 mg by JV. So I won't be giving this medication because it's once daily. So drug 2, calcium carbonate. Start date is today, finish date is ongoing, prescriber signature and bleep, Dr. Khan, bleep number 1, 2, 3. So today is dosage is 1.25 gram, frequency is twice daily, route is per hour, duration is ongoing, time by 8, it's been given by JD, but a code of 1. patient was not in ward. So this medication position is correct. It is, that's the bleed number. So I'll be giving this medication at my time. Dr. Ibarcio Prolo, date is today. Start date is today. Finishing date is ongoing. So dose is 5 mg, frequency 1 daily, the route is forever, duration ongoing, time is 14 seconds. Can I confirm my patient's current blood pressure? Okay, I will still be giving this medication to my patients.
Prescription charge for teleporter is the same as what I have on my previous charts. The details are the same, I'll have to proceed. Intravenous fluid, nothing has been prescribed yet. So I will only be administering calcium carbonate and metoprolol to you. Is that okay, teleporter? Okay, so I want to go and get your medications, I'll be back. So while I leave my patient side, I'll perform hand hygiene. Okay, I have calcium carbonate, and I have 1.25 gram was prescribed. 1.25 gram, yeah. So expiry date is 2026, and it is intact. And I'm happy to give this medication. I can see simply I'm happy to give. The medication is intact, the supra 5 milligram is very good 2026. It's intact and dry and it's very good to consume. It is safe for you that I'm happy to do. So I'll be picking this. It is safe for you that I'm happy to do. So I'll be picking just one of these. It is safe for you that I'm happy to do. So I'll be picking just one of this medication. Happy to do. Of this, the 5 milligram has been prescribed, so I'll be taking just one of these. The medication is in milligram, and according to so I have a vessel pull up 5 milligram, and according to the prescription, 5 milligram has been prescribed, so I'll be 2026. It's intact and dry, it's very expensive. It is safe for you that I'm happy to do. So I'll be taking just one of this medication. The calcium, would you like to take both together one after the other? Okay, so I will be giving you first the bisoprolol is for your blood pressure. Can you confirm to me you can swallow? Okay, so I'll give this to you. Have you used it? Okay. So I have your calcium carbonate here. It's for the your previous diagnosis. You know you had osteoporosis before, so I will be giving you this medication for that. It's strengthening your bones. Is that okay? Okay, so I will be giving you this. I hope you are fine. Can you confirm to me you swallow the medications? Okay, this is water. So you can confirm to me. Is there anything you want me to know before I leave? Okay, so let me just make sure that I've given.
And so I'll leave you now. If you have any other concerns, beautiful. I'll perform hand hygiene.
Okay.